Good afternoon, all of you. I'm KHSK Chayakudi, representing Department of Building Economics. My research topic is application of circular economy concept to pre-consumer apparel waste management in Sri Lanka. Moving to the presentation outline, this presentation comprised areas, research background, key literature findings, research methods, case study findings, finally conclusion. So apparel industry is considered as one of the major consumer good industries in the world, which is a vast industry. And as a result of this massive amount of apparel materials get wasted, a technical lifetime of a product, which is considered as maximum duration that product can physically function, has become least important factor because consumers are more concerned on aesthetic lifetime of a product. Based on a source of generation, apparel waste can be divided into two categories as post-consumer apparel waste and pre-consumer apparel waste. Developed countries generate most post-consumer apparel waste, while developing countries are generating more pre-consumer apparel waste. Reuse, recycling, incineration, and landfilling are the major disposal options which are prominently used in the world. This take, make, consume, and discard principles are considered as linear economy, and due to the series of challenges and underlying limitations of the linear economy, circular economy is the proposed solution for this problem. Moving to the key literature findings, pre-consumer apparel waste comprise four categories of waste, namely textile waste, packing waste, impurities, and other waste. Linear economy is considered as extract raw materials, sell, use, and discard as waste through incineration or dumping. Circular economy is about eliminating the concept of waste through closed loop cycles. Lean manufacturing is about eliminating the non-value added activities. Green supply chain management is about applied ecological concept to supply chain management. Extended producer responsibility is manufacturer is liable for entire lifetime of a product, taking back the product, reused and recycled and disposed. 3R concept is about reduce, reuse and recycle. So based on the several findings, research findings, it has been identified that there are several relationships and commonalities between these four concepts and circular economy. Therefore, circular economy will be implemented within the Sri Lankan context using these four waste management concepts. Moving to the research problem, within the Sri Lanka, apparel waste management is considered as has become a great concern. The absence of acceptable waste management systems to manage massive amount of pre-consumer apparel waste has become this waste management issue further complicated. So therefore, considerable amount of apparel waste sent to the landfilling or incineration. This linear economy significantly impact on human beings. Therefore, as a solution for these feedback loops are the major solution for this. So a circular economy, the major characteristics of circular economy is feedback loops. Therefore, the proposed solution for this problem is circular economy. The aim of this research is to enhance the effective pre-consumer waste management practices within the Sri Lankan context. Under that, there are four objectives comprised as namely, review the concept of circular economy, review the enablers and barriers, enhance the enablers while enabling the barriers, and finally develop a framework. This is the research methodology of this research. Qualitative approach has been selected as research approach. Under the qualitative approach, case study has been selected as research strategy, and eight semi-structured interviews were conducted, and gathered data was validated through four expert interviews. Finally, cross-case analysis and content analysis have been used as analysis tools. So these are the pre-consumer apparel base which has been find within the Sri Lankan context. So these are the implementation tools under each and every waste management concepts which are used to implement the concept of circular economy. As an example, under the lean manufacturing value stream mapping, Kaizen, JIT, Kanban, under the green supply chain management, partnering with suppliers who fulfill the sustainable requirements, partnerships are made with brands that are into sustainable manufacturing, under the extended producer responsibility, pollute-based principle, adhere with manufacturer guidelines, under the reduce, use both sides of paper, supplier asked to use less packaging, under the reuse, fabric offcuts are reused for handloom production, reusing fabrics and yarn corn after rebinding, under the recycling, chemical and mechanical recycling. So these are the case study findings. So under the case study findings, it was more concerned on enablers, barriers and strategies. So each and every enabler, barrier and strategies are divided into seven categories as economic, organizational, environmental, technical, marketing, social and legal. Under the economic enablers, So these are in a general manner, and also it is with the time constraints, it is not possible to go through each and every enabler barrier and strategy. So I will try my best to explain most influential enablers and barriers. And the enablers reduce the cost of profit maximization by eliminating the waste through lean manufacturing, business continuity in the market by adhering the sustainable guidelines, and the strategies properly match the production process in order to identify the waste and implement the relevant lean manufacturing tools. And the barriers, comparatively high cost on the automation projects, because most of the automation projects are high cost and due to the cost restrictions, companies are not allowed to implement these automation projects, and lack of and also under the strategies provide government support for the manufacturers who are adhering to sustainable guidelines. Under the organization enablers, availability of lean-based operating system, availability of innovation-driven culture within the organization. And also under the strategies, adhering with lean manufacturing tools to waste management and sustainable processes, implement lean-based maturity culture within an organization. Under the barriers, lack of employee engagement towards the lean manufacturing due to workload and target completion. And also under the strategies, organize theoretical and on-the-job trainings. Under the environmental enablers, management and brand retails philosophy towards the sustainability and large budget allocation for waste disposal, to adhere with government regulations such as EPL and SWML. Under the strategies, implement internal policies regarding supply quality and on-time delivery. Under the barriers, environmental pollution due to long-term transportation. As an example, most of the plants within one organization have been located within all over the country. Due to this issue, it has to be transport long distance. And also as strategies, empower the local manufacturers, reduce the environmental pollution from foreign transportation of materials. So under the technological enablers, availability of cutter machines. These CNC cutter machines are most efficient and effective, and also availability of software within the organization for waste management, waste optimization, such as ERP. So as strategies, R&D on international technologies, implement centralized software to include all stocks to identify the internal reusing opportunities within the organization, unavailability of suitable technologies to recycle the materials, and use of outdated technologies are one of the major barriers which can be identified, and also proper discussion between the brands and the manufacturers to identify the whole production process and for a production with the details in for the technical specification of the products can be identified as strategies. Under the market enablers and barriers, under the enablers, availability of suppliers who fulfill the organizational and brand retail sustainable requirements, availability of the suppliers who get back the products and after using them, organized training and awareness session for the suppliers to empower the raw material suppliers throughout the strategy, such as timely payment. Under the barriers, bargaining power of the brands, lack of local suppliers who fulfill the requirements of the organization, brands, and legal. Under the strategies, implement well-defined government rules and regulations can be identified. Under the social enablers, empower the local suppliers by purchasing materials to fulfill the requirements of the organization, empower the reuse and recycle vendors by creating job opportunities. Under the strategies, monitor and control the suppliers and vendors, regulate inspection on their processes. Under the barriers, lack of employee awareness regarding the different waste management approaches and implementation tools, on the job training program for machine operators, and government intervention towards implement the vocational training schools for the apparel sector within the support of manufacturer. Under the legal enablers, government regulation towards the supplier and manufacturer waste handlers, especially EPL and SWML. Under the strategies, establish proper audit and management basis within the organization. Under the barriers, rules and regulations of the administrations of BOI zones and lack of continuous monitoring system for this SWL, EPL and SWML, and simplify the BOI administration procedures and systems automation for easiness. So moving to the conclusion, so we can identify the apparel industry is one of the major export-oriented industries in Sri Lankan context, and it contributes a significant amount to the country's economy with the large-scale apparel production that will result to generate more pre-consumer apparel, which will end up in landfilling or incineration. So this study, As the study focuses on pre-consumer apparel waste management through the literature findings, different waste management approaches that have been identified in manufacturing, pre-supply chain management, extended produce responsibility, and 3R concept. So it was observed that industrial supervisors, cleaner production, material recovery, and engineering rampering are the concepts which can be further implemented this concept. Through the literature findings, it was found that circular economy is a sustainable concept which affects the three major areas, social, economic, and environment. When confirming literature findings with interviews with the industry practitioners, it was identified that implementation of circular economy concept not only affects society, economy, and environment, but also organization, technology, market, social, and legal perspectives as well. Therefore, suitable enablers and barriers have been identified throughout this research, and suitable strategies have been proposed. This is the recommendation for further research, exploring the brand retail's enforcement of the circular economy practices on large-scale apparel manufacturing manufacturers in Sri Lanka. Thank you.